Alrighty, I'm at KILG. I'm getting ready to depart. Got the flight plan loaded. I'll get going on up to 8,000 feet and direct to MXE, and we'll do the swap for GPS, Vovelock GPS. See what we get there. Alrighty, I'll come back in a few minutes and get en route. Alrighty, I'm just getting ready to go over to nav mode to pick up first segment here. And then once we get established, I'll go ahead and do the switch and see what we get. Yeah, I did look up the frequency for MXE. It's a 113.2, but I didn't put it in the nav receiver. I wanted just to leave that portion out for now, so when I do the swap, we're not worried about tracking the VOR or whatever. Alrighty, I'm at 3,800 feet. I'm on course, so I'm going to go ahead and do the swap right now to get over to Vovelock, and then I'm going to switch back. Okay, I'm going to go ahead and do this again. Over to Vovelock. This time I'll let it drift a little bit more to the right than it did before. Still in nav mode right here with the frequency selected for a VOR. Okay, I'll go back to GPS. See what happens. Normally to intercept, excuse me, GPS, we would select the heading mode and get on over there and then lock it up on that. Here we're just clicking buttons. It's something that I normally don't do. We'll see what happens here. It looks like it's trying to get back right onto the designated track. Again, I don't know if this is quite the action that the original host received. And then now we're ready for our next segment. Okay, I'm going to go ahead and stop the video now. It wasn't too bad, seeing I didn't select heading mode to get back on track. I'm going to go ahead and stop the video now.